This opens the door for Frank Lampard. Yet, he doesn't have a whole lot of managerial experience. Is he too green to right now get this Chelsea job, Craig?
I think so. And but, you know, there'll be those that say, no, no, he's ready. I think a year into a pretty good job he did at Derby, lost in the playoffs to Aston Villa. But not easy. It's a bare pit of a league to play in. And he had a lot of young guys and some on loan. I thought he did a good job there, but it is only a year. And if we're critical of Man United, and most of us have been, about the appointment of Solskjaer, who has much more experience than him, but is a former player, then I don't really see how... You know, if Chelsea are saying, as I believe, this is the number one target... Mm-hmm.
That's what the Guardian is saying.
This is the reporting, and this is the only person we really want, then you've got to question who's making the decisions. Hmm. Because you've got a club now that finished 26 points behind the league winners. You've got a club that sold its best player. You've got a club that's two of its youngest best talents is going to be out for months and months and months. And you've got a club who, depending on what Cass do, might not be able to sign any players. Now, the one thing I have heard is, well, this unites the fans. And what nonsense. It's the same I heard at United. Mm. Well, this gets the fans on our side. What the hell does that matter? Mm. Right, because fans get on a side of a club when a team performs on the field, right? When a team doesn't perform on the field, fans are not on that side. So it matters not a jot who you appoint. About fans will only be on side because they think it's Frank's been at Chelsea for years. This is a great appointment. We're all happy. Guess what? When results start going a little bit awry, like they did at Man United, things will change.
I think it's an appointment that the fans would clearly like, but as Craig rightly mentions, all that does is extend your honeymoon period a little bit longer. If results don't turn around, trust me, those fans will turn as well. And I'm with Craig on this. This doesn't make an awful lot of sense to me at all. Maybe you thinking, given the relationship between Lampard and Abramovich when he was a player, and those two somehow seemed to have a bit of a bond and grew close, that Abramovich is going to back him a bit more. I don't see that happening at all, given how arm's length Abramovich has been over recent years. It just does not make any kind... Those arguments don't hold any water for me, so I don't see why Chelsea have decided to go in this direction at all.
Frank comes in, he'll come in probably with Jody Morris, who was his assistant at Derby, another former Chelsea player, good coach, good guy, both good guys, there's no qualms there. But my only... thing is here is experience. And, you know, everybody's got to start somewhere, but a big turnaround is needed at Chelsea. A big turnaround. And, you know, I go back to it. It's a short-termism when you're saying this is appeasing the fans, because that's what Ed Woodward did at Man United. He was so soft and trying to appease the fans, he rushed out and gave Solskjaer the contract. And then it went downhill. So it's a big call all round if that's the case. But if that's the way Chelsea want to go, it's clearly saying we want somebody that we can control and that we probably are not going to spend a lot of money if indeed we can spend money on players.
You've both mentioned fans. Paolo, you're in England. What are folks there saying about this potential move?
Yeah, I mean, I haven't spoken to every Chelsea fan, but I feel like there's certainly a lot of warmth clearly towards Frank Lampard. There's lots of fans who, exactly as the guy's just been saying, will feel positive instinctively about seeing him on the bench. The funny thing is, we talked about it as is this something that will help deflect anger if results go the wrong way? If anything, part of me thinks, well, it'll only deflect the anger more quickly towards the board, because I don't think fans will jump on Frank Lampard if the results aren't going well. They'll blame everything around him. And it is a really difficult situation to walk into if this transfer embargo holds up, because you're losing Eden Hazard and not able to replace the most important player in your team. I think he's a choice that makes sense exactly as Craig and Shaq have just been saying. He makes sense from the board's point of view because you think, look, here's someone who, because of his love from the club, will say, OK, I accept this difficult situation. I want this opportunity. I believe I can work with the young players you have here. But I don't see it in a whole lot of other senses than that. I guess the one thing that is worth saying is, for the same reason, this job wasn't as attractive to other big managers. I mean, Max Allegri was discussed as a possible target for it, and my understanding is that he wasn't so keen to go to a club where he wouldn't have control over transfers, where he wouldn't have the opportunity to go out after targets he wanted. So it isn't just necessarily about Chelsea board looking after themselves. It's also about what options were open to them and were achievable quickly so that they could start getting ready for next season sooner rather than later. For more...
Sign up now for ESPN Plus.